Hello everybody,
my name is Nikita Tiwari and today we are going to solve some questions on C programming which have been asked in many exams like amcat and cocubes. So our today's topic will be data types and variables. Before starting with the questions, first we will see some basics of data types and variables. As you all are aware of this, that there are many data types available in C programming, such as integer, float, and variation of integer and float. Then we have character data type also, then we have boolean, etc. So we will be solving question on each of them one by one. So first of all, let's discuss the range of the data types. So here we can see the range of integer is 0 to 65535 for unsigned range. So let me first discuss what is unsigned and signed range. So in the unsigned range, we will have the values which are positive, whereas in signed integer, we will have positive as well as negative value. So if we consider that integer is of 2 bytes in our compiler, as we know that the size of the data type vary with the compiler to compiler. So let's suppose in my system I am having integer of 2 bytes, that is 16 bit. So here n, you can see in the formula we have n. N denotes the number of bits. So for unsigned range, we can go to 0 to 2 to the power n minus 1, that is 0 to 2 to the power 16 minus 1. 2 to the power 16 is nothing but 65536. When we will subtract minus 1, we will get 65535. But in signed range, we will be having positive and negative values. And the formula to calculate the signed range is minus 2 to the power n minus 1, 2, plus 2 to the power n minus 1, minus 1. So here, again calculating range of integer in signed, we will have minus 2 to the power 15, 2, plus 2 to the power 15, minus 1, and then finally we will get minus 32768232767. Like this we can calculate the range of any data type. We are supposed to know that what is the size of that data type, then we can calculate the range. Here are some points or some facts related to the integer data type. You can refer to these notes at our website, that is www.nathkeshgupta.com. There you can get all the content which we are discussing in the video. Next, here is the character data type. Some basic about the character data type, that it is of 1 byte. Signed character range is minus 128 to plus 27. Unsigned character range is 0 to 255. There is one important point related to the characters, that here we are having signed as well as unsigned character range. So when we go with the signed character range, it does not give us any additional feature. It just rotates the value according to the unsigned character range only. So we will see this rotation also in the questions which we are going to discuss. So here is the question, that a 10 bit unsigned integer has the following range. So just now we have seen the formula for calculating the range of unsigned integer. Unsigned, that means all values will be positive only, and we have to calculate it for the 10 bit. So the formula will be 2 to the power 0 to 2 to the power n minus 1. N here is 10. So 0 to 2 to the power 10 minus 1. 2 to the power 10 is 1024. So when we will subtract minus 1, we will get the range as 0 to 1023. So we can represent 0 to 1023 number in 10 bit unsigned integer. Here is the explanation of the same question, which you can get on the website. Next question is, Pracha want to store a list of binary data. Which of the following type should she use? So list of binary data. We always have to extract the important information from the question. And here it is a list of binary data. We know that binary means 0 or 1, either true or false. So, and we also know that the Boolean is the data type which can store only two values, that is true and false. So the correct answer for this question will be Boolean. Next question we have is, a data type is stored as a 6-bit signed integer. Which of the following cannot be represented by this data type? So 6-bit signed integer means 1 bit will be reserved for the sign, either plus or minus, and next 5 bit we can use to represent a number. Here we have minus 12, which can easily be represented by 6-bit integer. Again, plus 6 can also be represent with this. 18 also can be represented, but 32, we cannot represent 32 in a 6-bit signed integer, because as first bit is reserved for the sign and next 5 bits are for the number. So in the 5 bit we can only represent up to 0 to 31. So 32 we cannot represent in a 6-bit signed integer. I hope this is clear to you. Here is the explanation, which again you can find on our website. Next question is, a language has 28 different letters in total. Each word in the language is composed of maximum 7 letters. You want to create a data type to store a word of this language. You decide to store the word as an array of letters. How many bytes will you assign to the data type to be able to store all kind of words of the language? So again, we have to extract the important information from the question. It is saying that 28 different letters in total will be in a language. Each word will be of maximum 7 letters. Now we have to tell them that which, how many bytes or bit we will be taking to store this data type. So, as we know that character takes 1 byte. So, the correct answer for this will be 7 only, that there will be the 7 letters and each letter we can represent in a 1 byte, and hence the correct answer for this question will be 7. The next question is that Parul takes 2 input, A and B can take integer values between 0 and 255. So, there will be 2 variables A and B, and their value can lie between 0 to 255. She stores A, B and C as 1 byte data type. So, she is storing A, B and C in a 1 byte data type. She writes the following code statement to process A and B and put the result in a C. So, she is doing some arithmetic operation with A and B and storing the result in C. To her surprise, her program gives the right output with some input value of A and B, while gives an erroneous answer for others. For which of the following input will it give a wrong answer? So we have to tell that on which input the answer will be incorrect. So let's see how we will solve this question. First, we will try to get that what value C will get with the first option. So the equation is A plus 2 into B. So A here will be 200 plus 2 into B will be 20, that is 220. And before that, let's discuss one important thing also, that it is a 1 byte data type, and we know that 1 byte has 8 bits. So the range will be from 0 to 255. If the value of C will exceed 255, then we will get the erroneous answer or incorrect answer. So now let's solve it. Next we will see it with the next option, that is 10 plus 200 into 20. So it will give me 410. Next, with other options also we will get the value under 255 only, but with the second option we are getting the value which is exceeding our limit, that is 255. So B is the incorrect answer because the range is exceeding with this option. Here is the explanation of this question. Now let's see the next question. Here we have some code and we have to tell the output of the following C program fragment. So here we can see that we have two printfs, one printf and one printf inside the printf. So what is the behavior of printf? First we will discuss that. So printf, with printing the value on the console window, returns a value of how many characters it has printed on the console window. So first execution of this printf will get started, and it will first see that there is one format specifier percentage d, which will print the integer value. So then it will go to the next segment, that is printf percentage s. That means we have to print a string. Percentage s is the format specifier for the string. Then this string hello world will be printed. Then this printf, the printf which is inside a printf, will return the number of characters it has printed. So let's calculate how many characters we have here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, space will also be counted. 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11 and 12. Total 12 characters it is printing. So to this percentage d, it will return 12. Then we will get the output as a hello world. Then we will get 12. 12, why? Because the printer which is inside the printer is printing a 12 characters. So I hope that these questions will help you in your upcoming exam, and you will have the better clarity on the concepts which we have discussed. So if you like this video, please like and share. Thank you.